How to lay hand on people and train people to lay hand on people.
Akabunye sikulu wala tugenda kongere ngeri je bateka wa bantu engalo no ngeri je babasabira mu nga bwatade kengalo.
Because you know this is what Jesus has commanded.
Kubanga kino katon Yesu che yayogera ngalagira.
In Mark chapter 16 beginning of verse 15.
Mako 10 mukago kutalika 15.
It's talk about the Great Commission. That go to all the nations, preach to all the nations. And he who believes and is baptized shall be saved. And that miracles will follow those who believe. And what kind of miracles? What kind of miracles? That in Jesus' name you'll cast out demons. And you lay hand on the sick and they'll be healed. Now who can do it? Many people think just the pastors. But you pay attention to verse 17. Miracles follow those who believe. So everyone who believes can lay hand on people to experience healing and drive out demons. What happens is then you raise up an army to reach out to the people. Many times pastors just do it themselves. Then just the pastor, just this ministry have this power of Holy Spirit. But if all Christians do it, they can pray, lay hand on the friends, then the family members, the neighbors. And they can bring more people to Jesus. So I hope that you all want your members to reach out to the people.
Come on.
Not just you.
Come on.
Come on. So I hope you all want your members to reach out to the people and not just you reach out.
At
the same time, I want to say this. People who lay hands on people should have a good relationship with God. Spend time to build a relationship with God. To believe in God's love. To live in God's love. And love God all the time. So that he can have a strong anointing. And also take care of different problems in life. You know, sins and negative emotions, negative thinking. Can bring evil spirit. And also, negative emotions can affect the people being laid hand on. That evil, you know, that when people have evil spirit, it will be transmitted to people when they lay hand on other people. Why can that happen? Because, you know, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, God the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, created the angels. And then the angels, some of the angels fell and became demons. So in certain ways, the evil spirit can resemble the Holy Spirit.
Satan asobola kwefananyiriza ngo moyo mutukuvu.
Now they are very different. The Holy Spirit brings healing and love and joy and freedom. And it brings transformation of spiritual life. But evil spirit destroys spiritual life. And it causes people want to commit suicide or have anger. So the results are very different. But they are similar in some ways. The Holy Spirit can be transmitted by laying a lot of hands. The Bible has talked about different people laying hands on other people and then the Holy Spirit is transmitted to their person. It happened to me in 1998. When an evangelist laid hand on me, and I felt great power like electricity enter me. And I felt great love enter me. The love was so strong, I cried for a long time. And then I said, I did not know I can have such a close relationship with God. And I didn't know I can experience God like that. So I really want to keep this strong presence of God. And I spent much time praying. And also another thought came to me at that time. Another thought came to me at that time. If this evangelist can do it, I want to do it too. I want to lay hands on people that can experience the Holy Spirit. So I can bring spiritual transformation to people. And later when I did it, people's life was transformed. And there was a lot of healing. And demons driven out. My ministry was raised to a high level. And also the Holy Spirit taught me how to teach. Like this morning, the teaching about living in the love of God. And not to be accused by the law all the time. Was given to me by the Holy Spirit. That Jesus wants us to live in a free way. Because Jesus' yoke is easy and his burden is light. So I learned to just live in a very peaceful, free way. At the same time, I want to follow God's holiness totally. So God told me that any sin is destructive. That if I follow sin, it will destroy my ministry and my life. I will tell you, no one can run away from the eyes of God. I have known three pastors personally. Two of them were leaders of two denominations. All three of them committed adultery. All three of them, the life was destroyed to a great extent. Now, you don't have to commit adultery to destroy our life. When our life is not pleasing to God, God knows your heart. Whether you want to do ministry for yourself, or you do it for God. I've heard some people, I know some people, they lay hands on people. And they would do this. They'll push. Now, why did they do that? To make themselves look great.
Yes.
Do they serve God for people or for themselves or for God? So God taught me to take care of different problems, sins or negative thinking, negative emotions in my life.
So Katuni Amogamba, Alemo Kumanga, Akore Chito Nichinzo Kumulated HIV, Native Anagananga Chomo Ramu.
And have a heart just to be pleasing to God.
Era Aso Nti, Ava Asuro Kumanga, Agurumiza Katunda Yaka, Brikasea, which happened.
And God has told me that.
Era Katuni Amogamba.
Anyone who wants to please God, even when you cannot be perfect. Anytime when you sin, you say, God, forgive me. And all the time you want to love God, and you want to do things that pleases God, God knows your heart. Any small things you do for God, God is very happy. But if you have the heart to earn something for yourself, even if you have a big church, and you want to do it to say, I'm the greatest pastor. If God doesn't like it, then it's like you're building on the foundation of Jesus.
Amen.
And then you're tearing it down at the same time. Now when you build this church, do you build up one day and tear it down the other day? Okay, if you are doing that, then you are destroying your own life and ministry. So God taught me all that. So anytime if I have any pride, God told me that. And I said, Lord, it's for your glory. So people know you are good. So people like you. So people want to come to you and serve you. So God taught my life. And I thank God for that. It all came after I experienced the Holy Spirit. And I submit to the Holy Spirit. And I love God. It is not difficult. Let me ask you, is it difficult to work on the field out there in the sun? Is it difficult to work on the field out there under the sun? Is it difficult? Is it difficult? Let me ask you. To love God and love people and want to bless people, which is easier?
Loving
God and When you want to bless people, is it very difficult to bless them and help them?
Yes.
Is it very difficult? Which is more difficult? Let me ask you.
To
work on the field or to bless people, which is more difficult?
What did he say? Yeah, he has been
expanding. But which is more difficult?
To
work on the field, right?
Yes.
So,Actually, it's not so hard to be pleasing to God. I'm saying that.
So, okutwaiza wamu sichi zivuna akamu okukolera Katonda.
Now, although you know, I do work very hard.
Nelo akubadenga nkoye milime jamani.
I don't waste my time.
Sono nakadeka ngezi.
Yesterday in the car, I was talking to them, teaching them, guiding the pastors all the way in the car.
Yesterday, kasa kwa musisinga nyeku kunyoni, kisawo chenyoni. Yetani kidewo paka mubende. Ngedanga bamona amatu kwa garagata. Okuveringa tuyombesa ngatubulira paka mubende.
I do work hard.
Kuba akola nyo, okubanga bulira enjili yakato.
But it's not difficult work.
Na yesi mulimo gama, simulimo gwa manyi.
And I enjoy it.
Eranze chisanyukiramo okubanga bulira katonda, enjili yakatonda.
And God likes it and he blesses me.
Era katonda chakalira mpomu, ampomu kisakuru echo.
Do you want to be blessed by God?
Kali nawo yakakwera omukisa, katonda yakakwera omukisa.
It is not difficult.
Si chizibu.
And he blessed his land.
It's
okay. Now, I was talking about the Holy Spirit and evil spirit. After I experienced the Holy Spirit, I really responded to God. And my whole life was changed. So it was a great blessing to me. So I'm saying, the Holy Spirit brings good results. When people submit to God, and I was talking about the Holy Spirit and evil spirit are similar in some ways. The Holy Spirit can be transmitted by laying hands.
The
evil spirit can also be transmitted by laying on hands.
And
Jesus breathed or he blew at the disciples to receive the Holy Spirit.
Yes, yes, omuka mubayigirizwabe okufuna omoyo mutukuvu.
So the Holy Spirit can be transmitted by blowing people.
Era omoyo mutukuvu asobola okulabikibwa oba asobola okujja mukusa omuka mu bantu.
And the evil spirit can also be transmitted by blowing.
Era omoyo mubi gusobola okujja mukusa jasi mu muntu.
So when you raise up the prayer team in your church, you want them to learn to love God and take care of their sins and negative thinking and negative emotions, so that the whole life is following God. And then they will be pleasing to God. And then they lay hand on people and people can experience the Holy Spirit. But if they live in sin or worry or doubts, they could have evil spirit or negative emotions that can be transmitted to other people.
So,
now for me in Hong Kong, I raised up a prayer team. They have got used to counseling people and laying hands on people. I have many videos online on YouTube
aina videos nyingi ku YouTube ku mukutu kwa internet.
You look for Pastor Yip, Y-I-P.
Mumanyi Pastor Yip. Mumanyi, gwe baita Pastor Yip. Te mumanyi.
On YouTube.
You know, yeah, yeah.
YouTube and Facebook.
Gogenya ku YouTube, ni ku Facebook. Pastor Yip, yono.
Y-I-P. And you can see my videos.
Musobola okulaba videos.
And many people saw my videos.
Era abantu banje banaba videos ze njiri.
People contact me all the time.
Abantu benye ngelo okumu okumu okumutumira nokumubuzako.
And then my prayer team and I counsel them and pray for them.
Era abantu ne batandika okubanga babaga babachalire. Timu ye ne bachali ya ne babasabira.
So my prayer team get used to ministering to people.
Era etimu ye kati.
And they have strong ownership of the ministry. They have a sense of responsibility for the ministry. So when I'm away, they preach there. And they take care of the meetings. So I ask you, do you want to raise up people like that in your church?
Yes.
So it's not just you. But your members, those who love God, those who are willing to follow God, and then you let them know God loves you all the time. God has a lot of blessings waiting for you. When you follow God, His blessings will keep coming to you. And I have shared with them too how God has blessed me in many ways. Now this morning, this lady said that she had a vision that, did you see me or just someone will be coming to this place? Let me ask her. Let her answer.
Amen.
Come on.
Praise the Lord. I thank the Lord. Because these people who are here. Amen. Before they came, this year, past Mass, I saw the visitors who were here. They were visitors. I don't know where they were coming from. So I went to my pastor. That one, who is pastor? I told him, Pastor, we might be having visitors here. And those visitors are white who are coming here. So she phoned them when they are in this church. She phoned people carrying things here, they are bringing in this church. So Pastor replied to her, if God wishes, we will do. You will come. So she's thanking the Lord because the Lord has fulfilled it. Okay.
So she just saw a vision.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Thank God. Let me tell you. Now you can go back to your seat. She's the 10th person who have seen me coming before I went to the place. 10th person. She's the 10th person. That in South Africa. There was a woman, when I went to the church, she said, I dream of you last night. And then, in my dream, she was being chased by someone and she was afraid.
And
then later she saw me. And I said to her, do you want me to pray for
you?
In the dream, she experienced joy and love. She was so happy, she woke up laughing. And then she told me, the person in the dream looked like you. And when I pray for her, she experienced the joy and the love is the same as in the dream and in reality. I'm telling you, you are the 10th person. What I'm saying is, when any one of you love the Lord, you really want to follow God and serve God, God is very happy with you. And He bless you in many different ways. It's not just me. When I share with you, I'm just telling you, if God knows that you love Him, He'll remember you and He'll bless you. Let me tell you another example. One time when I went to Africa also, when I was transferring from one plane to another, I miscalculated the time and missed a plane.
Yes,
and then I asked the person that they said that, well, you missed the plane, you have to rebook your ticket. And I went to the rebooking counter. And the person said it's very difficult because you bought a ticket in Hong Kong. And then I prayed to God. God, you have a way to fix this. Because you're almighty. And then I asked the woman again, please make a phone call and find out again. And then she made a phone call again. And then when she was making a phone call, her eyes were wide open. And then she said, the plane has come back. I asked the people in the plane later what happened. They said that the plane just could not take off. They keep trying. And finally the pilot said, The plane cannot take off. We have to turn back. So she told me, you can get on the plane now. I'm telling you, when you love God, God can do the impossible for you. Even a plane can come back for you. The plane could not take off without me. Let me ask you, do you want to really love God and obey God and serve God? And do it for God's glory. You know, as pastors, you don't just do ministry yourself. To be faithful, you train your members so that they do ministry.
Yeah.
Yeah. because the pastor are supposed to raise up people to serve God. And then God said, you are a faithful servant. Okay. Yes. Now, so I talk about how we can carry the power of God to pray for people. Now, I'm going to give you some Bible verses. Please write down the Bible verse. So when you pray for people, then they experience the Holy Spirit. And then you can tell them, this is what the Bible has said. That what you experience is what the Bible has promised. And then you can say to them, if God has blessed you like this, do you want God to bless your whole life? Do you want to believe in Jesus and follow Jesus, and your whole life will be blessed? So you can bring people to Christ by praying for them. This method I call experience God evangelism. And also raise up people to serve God. When I pray for them, and they saw me pray for other people, and saw how people experience the Holy Spirit, and they can see that they can serve God too. Because they might practice praying for people and they saw that they can carry the power of the Holy Spirit too. And then many of these people are willing to serve God. So by laying hand on people, I can bring people to believe in Jesus. I can also raise up the spiritual life of people and help people to love God and to serve God.
Yes,
and you can do the same too. And that is God's way of ministry. Okay, now just write down these verses. John 14:27. There it says that Jesus said, peace I live with you, my peace I give you.
Nti mbareke de mirembe ere mirembe jange njiba wadde batusomere yo Yokana 14:27.
Okay. Now some people
Emirembe mbalekera. Emirembe jange ngibawa. Sinde si bwe wanzi. Bwembawa. Omutima gwa mwe tegwera likiriranga. So tegutyanga.
Okay. Now some people said this is what Jesus said, not the Holy Spirit. This is what Jesus said.
Eyetino. Yesu cheya yogera. Watu gwe yogera.
But let me tell you, the Father, God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit are one. So what the Father and Jesus Christ does, the Holy Spirit also does. So the Holy Spirit brings peace to people. That you feel peaceful. Now, this is the most common experience. Many people say they feel very peaceful, very calm. Okay, and then second experience. Matthew 11:28. Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. What it says is, come to Jesus and you'll find peace when you're burdened. Now, this is also a very common experience. People feel the burdens go away. At first they were worrying, and then the worry went away.
Okay.
And then Psalm 16 verses 8 to 9. Every verse you say twice.
Yes. Zaburi kuminamunana. So kuminamukaga munana pakamwenda.
There it says that I've set the Lord always before me, because he's at my right hand, I will not be shaken. Therefore my heart is glad, my tongue rejoices, and my body also will rest secure.
Nti ntende katonda mas ntende mukama. Nteka mukama bulijjo mu maaso gange, kubanga kye kitangaala kyange, era sirinyenyezebwa nate. Batusomereyo tuwulire.
Okay.
Zaburi batusomereyo 16:8-9. Zaburi 16:8-9.
Mukama mutadde mu maaso gange.
Tuwulira.
Kandemu. Mukama mutadde mu maaso gange bulijjo. Kubanga ye ali ku mukono gwange ogwa ddyo. Sirisagasagana. Omutima gwange kyeguva gusanyuka. N'ekitiibwa kyange kijaguza, era n'omubiri gwange gunaabeeranga mu mirembe.
Amina.
Okay, so it says that in the presence of God,
so mukubeerawo kwa Katonda,
my heart is glad,
nti omutima gwange gw'amaanyi,
that it can bring joy,
era kusobola okuleeta essanyu.
Now this morning, some people feel the burdens go away.
Era kumatanga bwe mawulidde amaanyi ebizibu bye babadde balina byagenze.
Some people experience joy. And then my body also will rest secure.
Let
the body feel comfort. Many sick people feel the sickness go away. Or they feel the body very light.
That
they feel comfort
in the body.
So that's why I ask people. And usually I say, please keep your eyes closed. Have you experienced anything in your heart? And over your body. And many people say, I feel peaceful. I feel the burdens go away. I feel joyful. And I feel the body really light and in comfort.
And
I tell them this is what the Bible promised. And if God has blessed you like this, do you want to be blessed by God for your whole lifetime? And then I bring them to believe in Jesus. Or to serve God. And then Psalm 4, verse 8. I will lie down and sleep in peace for you alone, O Lord. Make me dwell in safety.
Zaburi nya munana. But some of you today.
Mobotatia Nagala Miranga Nenevaka. Kubanga Goweka Mukama Antusa Mumirembi.
Amina.
So what it says here, it will help people to sleep better.
Ah, Kubanga Yevaka Mumirembi.
Now, one time a woman brought her daughter to me. The daughter was about 20 years old. She had been going to a university. But because she could not sleep, she had to drop out of the university. And then when I prayed for the girl, in the first night she stopped to sleep. And after that, her sleep kept better and better. And she went back to the university and finished her degree. Now, I have different examples like that. One time, I was in a meeting praying for people. And the next day, I asked them what has happened. And one woman ran up. She said for over 10 years, she had only slept for 2 hours every night. And after the prayer, for the first time she slept for 8 hours, and glory to God, you know, many people have sleeping problems. Many people have sleeping problems can get cured. But of course, we also want to counsel people. Counsel people. To help people handle the problems in life. Okay, now another verse. Isaiah chapter 61, verses 1 to
3.
Now this talk about inner healing.
Yesaya kagamwemu okutandikirako mpaka satu.
This talk about inner healing.
Anti wano wogera okuonyezebwa ko munda. Okuonyezebwa ko munda.
Yesaya
kagamwemu. Kagamwemu akanyira akashoka mpaka satu.
Omoyo gwa mukama katonda guli kunze. Kubanga mukama mfuse kwa mafuta okubulira ebigambo okubulira abawombefu ebigambo ebirungi antumye okusiba abalina emitume egimenyese okulangirira eddembe eri abawambe n'abasibe okugulirwawo ekomera okulanga omwaka gwa mukama ogw'okukkirizibwa n'olunaku lwa Katonda waffe olw'okuwalanirwamu eggwanga okusanyusa bonna abalwadde abanakuwadde okubateekerawo abanakuwadde abanakuwaludde mu Sayuni okubawa engule mu kifo ky'ebbu amafuta ag'okusanyuka mu kifo ky'okunakuwala ekyambalo eky'okutendereza mu kifo ky'omwoyo ogw'okukungubaga balyoke bayitibwe miti gya butuukirivu Mukama gyeyasimba alyoke aweebwe ekitiibwa ye.
Amen.
Okay, what it says here is, the Spirit of the Sovereign Lord is on me, because the Lord has anointed me to preach good news to the poor. He has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim freedom for the captives and release from darkness for the prisoners, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor and a day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all who mourn, and provide for those who grieve in Zion, to bestow on them a crown of beauty instead of ashes, the oil of gladness instead of mourning, and a garment of praise instead of spirit of despair. They would be called oaks of righteousness, a planting of the Lord for the display of His splendor. So these verses talk about inner healing of the Holy Spirit. Now this verse is like the Great Commission of the Old Testament. Because it says that the Spirit of the Lord is upon me to send me to preach good news to the poor. So it's sending out people to preach the good news.
So Katonda,
but not just to preach the good news, but to heal also the brokenhearted.